I think protecting children is a moral imperative of any just society, and today we get to see an example of it. Hi everyone, welcome to today's lesson here at Active Self Protection. I'm your host, John Correa. Today's video comes to us from West Midlands in England. Big Tech's Outdoors has holsters, accessories, optics, and other parts that you need as a self-defender. I'm one of his customers and I recommend him highly. Check out the page on our website with our favorite deals. You can see on the right side here down the sidewalk, mom walking her two little kids, and there's a dog following them that's a Rottie that apparently got out from a shop down the street. And you can see that Rottweiler's just kind of checking things out. Mom doesn't like him real much, and she's kind of paying attention. Why is this dog just kind of following us? So she's going to pick up the little one in the red jacket, the little bit older ones in the blue jacket, and they're going to cross the street. Now watch what happens with the dog here, as he's going to come over and decide he wants to come over and see what's going on with them and kind of bark a little bit, whatever. That's going to run the little one back to mom, and now it's going to get ugly as the dog's predator drive is going to kick in here, and it's going to start snapping at the girls, and mom's trying to push him off. Now watch the dog here jump in, bite the one in the red jacket, and now grab a hold of the leg of the little girl in the blue jacket. And now mom's kind of trying to get her little one away and just wondering kind of what to do, grabbing a hold of her little one, and that makes the dog's shake reflex come in. He starts shaking this little girl pretty good. Now she's screaming, obviously everybody's screaming. There's a version with audio you can go listen to. I'll link it in the description. But a bystander hears what's going on and she jumps out and decides, oh no, what are we gonna do? And now another guy jumps in and starts getting after the dog, trying to get a hold of this little girl. And he does so, kicks the dog a little bit here. And once he stomps the dog a little bit, the dog is gonna let go. Now he picks the older one up here and is gonna kick a couple more times at the dog. And you see, they put the little girl in red inside the car. And now he is actually gonna, you know, dog circle around a little bit and give them just a second to put the other little girl in the car. And now what we're gonna do is switch perspectives here, because there's another angle that we have that the dog's gonna run off down the road. Now, those two little girls in the car, according to the news stories that I've linked in the description, both were bleeding. The older one in the blue jacket had some injuries and ended up needing to go to the hospital and spend some time there. So now they're just trying to figure out what to do with the dog here and how to get that dog back. News story says that eventually the owner figured out the dog was out, came and put a leash on it, but the dog has then been surrendered to authorities. They're looking at perhaps putting charges on the owner, but the two bystanders that came in here and helped are considered heroes in their community, and that's where we end. Man, thank God for courageous bystanders, and I think there are sometimes you just gotta step in. What about you? Do you think this is one of those times that you're like, look, even though it's dangerous for me, I'm gonna step in? Or are you like, hey man, not my circus, not my monkeys? I hope the former. A lot of stuff to think about here. I do like mom's instinct that says, you know what? I don't like a random dog here. And so paying attention to your environment, good. Taking steps to make yourself safer, good. But also use this time to plan. Okay, if that dog gets aggressive, what am I gonna do here? Hey, I wanna get my kids away from this dog to see if I can just keep the dog at bay. But if that fails, what am I going to do to protect my children from this dog? I think that's a very important lesson for us to think through here. Now, I also want you to notice that she is paying attention to this dog. You notice she's not just, okay, kids, let's get out of the way. She is seeing that there's a threat here. So again, my biggest thing is to mentally prepare so that you have attitude to protect yourself. Then you also have the skills, and that means tools, and also empty-handed skills, and then a plan. What am I going to do if this dog decides to come across the street? Now, of course, this is the UK, and they can't carry any defensive tools there at all. No knives, certainly no guns, no pepper spray. But I'm gonna talk about that from the perspective of not just where they are, but where I live in the US and how we would respond to this. So now notice a dog decides to come across the street. Mom does make an error here by she goes back towards the other child to stay away from the dog. But again, your instinct here, you gotta control and say, if that dog starts coming my way, I'm gonna put myself between the dog and my children. And that big first thing says, I'm gonna be a shield. Now, what is it that you're gonna do to a dog that big? Well, you may not have a lot of skills, but this is why you gotta have an attitude first that says, listen, I'm gonna give this dog a good swift kick in the face if he comes towards my children. Now, of course, if you're a tool user, this would have been the time to step in between the dog and your kids and give him a good OC spray, like right now. And it's very effective on dogs. I've actually had to do it 3 times, not with kids around, but with my dogs around. Now, I want you to also notice that now she's got both of her children with her and on her. So again, at this point, I think the dog is so close that if you'd have tried something like an OC spray, you probably get secondary contaminants on yourself, would have been very difficult, and she doesn't have the hands to do so. So this is why, again, you want to step out in between. So now that you know you have a little bit of space when you deal with the dog, stepping in there early saves you from problems later, like she's going to have with the dog starting to chase her around. Now, I get it that it's a natural inclination to pull your child away from the dog, but that engages the dog's predator drive. Again, when you start saying, look, I'm gonna take your the thing that you're interested in away, that makes the dog chase, which then can engage their drive to bite and eat. And so you don't wanna do that. What you wanna do instead is, again, step between and put a barrier between and start to get big on the dog and say, get away from my stuff, and stay between the dog and what it is that they are looking for. And again, that might mean you need to get violent, but that's what ends up happening here. Now notice, because she doesn't do that, she ends up in a big pile with the dog having bit the smaller child. Bad spot to be in here with, you know, on the ground with the dog biting your child, whatever, but this is where you gotta go all out. This dog is gonna hurt my children. Now I've gotta get in the mix. And yes, you might get bit, but better you get bit than your child gets bit. And this is why you might wanna spend just enough time learning, listen, I'm gonna choke this dog into unconsciousness at this point. And that's where empty-handed skills, something like jiu-jitsu, something like combat, you know, wrestling, those kinds of things can really help you to get, you know, a willingness to get in there. And I've seen dogs actually get choked out, not on kids, but on animals. I used to live on a farm, and I've seen my adopted pop do that to a dog before. Now, you notice here that dog now has a hold of that child's leg. And I know somebody's going to ask, wait a minute, John, at what point could I shoot that dog? Certainly, once a dog starts attacking a child, it's a threat of great bodily harm to that child, and deadly force is justifiable morally and legally in order to protect from the dog. But would you have had the ability, very difficult shot here, without endangering one of the children, of any kind of a use of a tool? Sometimes you just gotta get in there. But I also want you to notice that she's trying to, again, pull her child away from the dog, which instigates the dog's shake response, and that's not gonna fly. You gotta get on that dog. Now, of course, let's think about the next one, getting involved as a bystander. And I know you hear me say this all the time on the channel, to be very cautious of getting involved in a bystander, because there are dangers to you. But there are some things that are so shocking to the conscience of humanity that you have to get involved, that you just can't say no. And I think a dog mauling a child is 100% one of those times. So I would encourage you, think about these things ahead of time so that, again, you've already got your plan in place. That if I see a dog mauling a child, I'm getting involved there, so then that way I can be a part of doing good. You've got to protect the child in this instance. And I applaud this woman, but she doesn't have any skills to back that up, so she wants to help, but what is she gonna do? Now, same thing with this other guy. Now, what are we gonna do? Now, notice when things start changing here, I think it's important for us to notice, it's when the guy kicks the dog that things get to changing. Why? Because if stepping in between doesn't matter, sometimes the only thing a dog is gonna listen to is, ouch, it hurt me, in order to do this thing that puts the child in danger. And sometimes, friends, that means you need to be ready to do violence, and yes, even violence to a dog. I know people say, oh, you know, my dogs are my kids or whatever, but hogwash. A dog is not worth what a child is. A child is a human being made in the image of God and is of inestimable value, worth, and dignity. And therefore, if you gotta do violence to a dog to protect a child, do it all day, every day. And notice here that it's the violence, that the guy being willing to be violent enough got the dog to leave the child alone enough for them to get the children out of the danger zone. And I think that's a very admirable thing, that they finally said, let's get the kids out of the way to remove that predator drive. And that changes the dog's behavior. Now the dog is not being aggressive and attacking anymore. Notice he's got his tail up and he's just running through the neighborhood trying to see what's going on. The one thing I would say at the end here is, you got two children inside that car who are hurting. Great reason to have your medical equipment on you. Great reason to have your training so that you can triage the injuries of these little ones while you get them to the hospital. And I don't think either one of them needed a tourniquet in this case, but carrying a good tourniquet, very important. The Committee of Tactical Combat Casualty Care approves the CAT tourniquet and the soft tee for pediatric use, or a good compression bandage for that. So that's the one I recommend that you carry, and also to have the skills to be able to use it. So I applaud these bystanders. I think they did a phenomenal job, and they should be absolutely just given all the acclaim in the world for helping save these little girls. I think as a parent, you really gotta think through these things. I think having tools on you, the best tools available on you, is a good thing and important, and I recommend that you do. But remember, attitude is more important than tools. Skills and a plan go a long way to cover your ass.